Fred Film Radio. I'm David Martos. This is the 67th edition of San Sebastian Film Festival, and we're here with Ina Weise, director of The Audition, Das Vorspiel. Hello, how are you?
I'm fine, thank you very much.
Director,
have you seen the film? Yes, of course.
Of course.
When?
This morning.
Ah, 9 o'clock.
Just a few hours ago, yes.
Okay, so I'm interested.
Why is that?
No, I'm interested. What do you think?
I can tell you that after the interview. Okay. I never give my opinion before.
Okay, good. Oh, good.
So, first of all, it's more than 10 years since your previous film, right?
Yes. But I did between one a documentary about the National Gallery in Berlin. Mm-hmm. It's about architecture. And then I played as an actress. So 10 years, yes, long time. But I needed time to write the script with my co-writer, Daphne Arizani. Mm-hmm. But 10 years is a long time, yeah.
I think it's a tough film about self-consciousness, about what we expect from ourselves, about expectations in one's life. What do you want to tell with this film, to tell us?
That's a very big, because I did the film that you tell me what you see.
Okay.
So, you know. Yes, I want to tell something about education, about childness, mm-hmm. about power, Macht, power about children. They are the schwächste Glied der Kette.
The weakest
in the chain. And I wanted to tell something about Zerrissenheit. To be divided inside. And a post about a person like Anna. And I wanted to tell something about about the musician world.
Yeah, the musician world, I mean, the world of music, your leading character is a professor. She's a teacher, a violin teacher, who is very serious about what she does and what she demands from the pupils. Do you think we are asking for too much in these days? I mean, wouldn't we be happier if we relaxed a little?
Of course, you would be happier if you're relaxed. But sometimes it's not possible to relax. If you have this goal and you want to come to this tone, like she in the film, she has to fight, and then she falls down, and then she goes up, and then he fight again. I think that's the way of life, and that's the way. If you work with art and with music, you have talent, some percent, you need talent, but then it's a lot of work. You have to hear the small, the boy, the student, he plays 3 or 4 hours a day. You know, that's a lot, that's hard, that's not a childness, he would say. But for him it is a childness, but because he likes what he does. So, yes, you can say it's better to relax, but I think for him not. Because he really loves what he does.
But what about the character of Anna, about Nina Hoss? I mean, because there's a fine line between performing in your profession, in your job, being really great, being, for example, a violin teacher, and forgetting family, forgetting personal life, putting all that behind your profession. Are you interested in that frontier between performing in your career and the family and personal life, which is a really strong issue for women nowadays, because...
Yes, but I'm interested about people who tries to find their place in the world and to find their place in themselves and in work and in family, and that's not easy.
How do you feel returning to be a director, like you said, couple of years after your last film, the documentary and the architect. In your first feature film, I think you were somehow learning like the basics of being a director, and now you have this experience of having directed twice.
I must tell you, I was in a film that, of a directing school. I made a directing school it's not 20 years ago. And I make, I don't know, 6 short films. Mm-hmm. And so it was always, and if you work too as an actress, you are always on you're always working with stories on the film set. And so it's, for me, not 10 years, I did nothing, and oh God, that's what I'm doing now. So it was not like that for me. So
precisely, the question was, how did you find the difference between you as a director 10 years ago and now, with all the things you kept building up, like as an actress, as a director too? I mean, how did you change in this 10 years gap?
That's a good question. Perhaps I have more trust
in yourself,
in the others, and trust to give them more space. But I don't know how it was 10 years ago. Perhaps I'm genauer, more precise in details too. In camera, in buildings, in how the school is, how they are living, in all these small details, I would say that I take more care than 10 years ago. And but I can say it's really a big change, because the films are so different. That the architect, it was a lot of snow, it was the first film, it was overwhelming everything. And here I have another problem. Here is the violence, many, many children with violence. Not a lot of time, 5 hours a day I can shoot with them, with children in Germany. Only 28 days shooting in general. So it was... Oh, it was like that, you know. But okay, every film is hard to make, of course. But it was so different to the other film that there was no compare, kein Vergleich in myself now. And the actors were different. Oh, not Sophie Reuss. She's the other teacher. She was in my film before 10 years ago. So.
I presume that as an actress, you like collaborating with your directors and contributing to the roles you make. How do you leave that when you are the director, like actors contributing to your project? Do you?
I love this. Yes, but I love with Sophie Reuss, with one of the actresses, I did it, and I love it very much. But now it was really another project, and I didn't write it for something specially. Mm-hmm. And because it's not very easy to write for this special person, because you're a little bit closed in your mind, as for me. And so I lost the I lost the way.
We're talking about actors contributing to their roles in their work with the directors.
Yes, I know. And so, okay, thank you very much. Okay. So, it was another piece, another film, and so there was no role for the other actors in my other film. I can say this, yeah.
So Ina Weise, director of Das Vorspiel, thank you very much.
Thank you very much. And I'm very sorry for my bad English.
Our English is bad. Our English is rusty, but
better.
People are going to understand us. Thank you very much. This was an interview for Fred, the Festival Insider.
Thank you.